Oh, a disaster befell the fellers that rode for the old Circle B. And it weren't flood, fire, or famine. 'Twas somewhat worse than all three. Seems the fellers had taken to teasing the cook about the grub that he served. And they laughed when he said that he'd leave 'em. But old Cookie was good as his word. When the fellers rolled out the next morning, the cook shack stood empty and still. And the note that they found on the table said, "You cook it, boys, then eat your fill." Now, cowboys are downright resourceful. They found them the old coffee pot, and they boiled up a gallon of coffee. Laughed about Cookie a lot. And oh, they decided that they was real sorry for the things that they'd said and they'd done. That at lunch they'd explained to old Cookie their teasing had just been in fun. Well, when the fellers rode back in for noon meal, old Cookie was nowhere around. So lunch was leftover cornbread that one of the fellers had found. Well, the rest of the day they spent dreaming about beefsteak and biscuits and beans, about taters and coffee and cobbler and fruit pies like you never seen. They just knew when they rode in that evening, old Cookie would lay out a spread. But when they rode in that evening, the cook shack was cold as the dead. Canned peaches, sardines, and Wheaties was the supper the fellers whipped up. And since no one would do any dishes, it was served up in styrofoam cups. Well, when the fellers retired to the bunkhouse, they was fuming, soured, and mad. Why, they'd just handle the cooking. Didn't need no cookie, by damn. When the sun come up the next morning, breakfast was laid out by Homer and Sam. Oh, there was biscuits and gravy and taters, burritos and eggs and ham. But them biscuits was blacker than charcoal. The gravy, thicker than paste. The taters was ashes and cinders, and the eggs, nuclear waste. The ham, it was something like leather. But them burritos, they'd not soon forget. 'Cause each man had to eat about 50. See, Homer had rolled 'em just like cigarettes. Well, Billy said that he'd cook up the noon meal, that he'd boil up a big pot of beans all flavored with herbs and with spices, the height of cowboy cuisine. Said he'd learned from watching his mama. Said he knew just how it was done. So when you ride back in at noontime, boys, spur 'em. Come at a run. Well, when the fellers come in at noontime, the aroma was downright sublime. Old Billy had whipped up some victuals. The boy, he'd come through this time. Now, have you ever dropped rocks in a bucket and heard the sound that they make? Well, that's pert near the sound that them beans made when spooned onto each cowboy's plate. Old Billy, he knew how to cook 'em. That part he had down just right. But it seems he'd forgot about soaking them pintos all day and all night. Well, the boys drifted out to their horses, mounted up, and rode back to work. Poor Billy, he threw out the noon meal, put on some coffee to perk. When the moon come up that same evening, the boys was a pitiful sight. They sat round the cook shack table, bemoaning their terrible plight. They were pale and gaunt and skinny. They were weak and starting to fail. Looked like they'd been drugged through a knothole, backwards, by the tail. One by one they slunk off to the bunkhouse. Nary a word did they speak. Most didn't feel much like talking, and some was just plain too weak. All that night there was moaning and wailing, which gave way to whimpers and sighs, then turned to a dreadful silence. You'd have thought that all of 'em died. Then sometime just before the sunrise, there come a familiar sound, the rattle of old Cookie's pickup as he came driving back in from town. Well, the boys, they turned out to greet him. They carried his stuff to the shack and told him how much they had missed him, how happy they were that he was back. They said that they was real sorry they'd teased him. They swore that was all in the past. From them, he'd hear nothing but praises. That teasing, sure enough, in the past. Now, it's been years since this episode happened. Every meal has been greeted with smiles, and the fellers have bragged about their cookie for hundreds and hundreds of miles. So if you're looking to find you a fist fight, if you're needing your face rearranged, just tell the boys from the old Circle B that their cookie ain't king of the range.